We have bought two gliders on AliExpress for a price of about €2 each. The wingspan of these planes is 48 centimeters. Then, we made a twin-fuselage aircraft. One end of each wing has been cut, and both wing have been joined in the cut. The total wing has been reinforced with a carbon fiber rod 2.5 millimeters in diameter and 65 centimeters in length. The wingspan is now 79 centimeters. The area of the main wing is 0.0612 square meters. The carbon fiber rod is not able to keep the wings straight, so they are bent down under their own weight. This produces a negative dihedral angle that causes the lateral instability of the aircraft. Therefore, we have tightened the wings with a thread to keep them straight. The ailerons have been cut directly from the wings. On top, wooden sticks have been placed to define the hinge line well. In addition, strips of thick packing tape have been arranged to fix the hinge. On the trailing edge, stakes have been placed to prevent the deformation of the ailerons. The elevator has been made from an extruded polystyrene sheet cut from a food tray. This has a width of 2.5 centimeters and is sewn in 3 points to the horizontal stabilizer. We have placed wooden sticks to reinforce the tails and stabilizers. We have placed EVA rubber pieces that will serve to cushion landings. The motor is placed suspended in the center by a wooden stick structure of 3 millimeters in diameter. We did not want to make a solid gondola for the motor so as not to waste the central section of the wing. The cables are passed from one side to the other by the leading edge of the wing, so as not to modify the airfoil. We use an F10820 brushless motor. This motor provides a maximum thrust of 180 grams with a 4-inch diameter and 4.5-inch pitch propeller. The ESC is 12 amps. The servos are 3.7 grams. The largest battery that we can place is one of 350 mAh and 21 grams of weight. This battery approximately compensates for the symmetrical weight of the ESC and receiver. If we add a larger and heavier battery, we have to compensate for this extra weight in the fuselage on the left by adding dead weights in the fuselage on the right. We avoid adding dead weights that decrease the aerodynamic capabilities of the plane. However, 6.5 grams of plasticine are added on the left side to set the center of gravity in the first third of the wing chord and on the symmetrical axis of the plane. Later, we will try to reduce this weight by reorganizing the position of the different masses of the aircraft. The final weight of this first version, with the plasticine included, is 205 grams. The thrust to weight ratio is 0.89. The wing load is 3.3 kilograms per square meter. In the first flight tests, the center of gravity is located, which is 3.5 centimeters from the leading edge of the wing, which corresponds to 38% of the wing chord. It is noticed that the 4-inch propeller only provides the necessary thrust by pushing the power stick above 50%. Therefore, the propeller is changed for a 5-inch diameter and 4-inch pitch propeller. Due to the change to a larger diameter propeller, wooden sticks are added to protect the propeller during landings. The canopies are placed, which have been previously hollowed out. The piece of plasticine that was used to set the center of gravity on the axis of symmetry of the plane is now placed on the final tip of the left wing. By quadrupling the arm of this mass with respect to the center of gravity, we can put a quarter of plasticine by weight. So finally, we add a little less than 2 grams of plasticine. The weight of this version is 203 grams. The wing load is 3.3 kilograms per square meter. We assume the thrust to weight ratio, with the change of propeller, to be greater than 1. Flight autonomy is about 6 minutes. The final images of the plane are shown. And this is all, thanks.
Dale más potencia, sí, que sí. Se cae, vale.
Sí, no. Ya.